Hello, Bumpy McSquiggums here. It's time for some more Risen. This is episode 3, and we are about to go into the swamp camp and deal with the Don's men. Who knows what's going to happen? Well, I kind of do, but most of you don't know, so we'll see. Does he just randomly talk to me? We have a quest journal or something, I'm pretty certain. Don't remember how to check it, though. That's kind of a problem. Forgive me while I, there we go. Our current quest is nothing. We have no current quest. That's kind of interesting. Alright, so we have a world, we have Harbor Town, we have Volcano Keep, Bandit Camp, and all. Interesting. We've completed these quests thus far, and, well, we have a region map, we have a quest map, I mean, all sorts of stuff. I don't even think I ever used that before, to be 100% honest, so I guess we'll just start talking to folks. Any trouble today?
Any trouble today?
Yes, I don't need to talk.
No. Expecting any?
No.
Must be fun being a guard.
Not really.
What exactly do you guard in a swamp?
Flies. The smell. The Don.
The Don.
Back there in that temple. But my post is here. In the swamp.
Sounds like an important job. What is there around here that people need guarding from?
You must have seen them.
Seen what?
Those things.
Those things.
The things from the ruins.
Well,
there are ruins everywhere.
The ones that came up from the ground. The ground is warped or something.
Okay.
That's where these things are.
Yeah. They're all over that excavation site in the middle of the swamp.
Intriguing.
And they make me nervous.
Why?
They're disgusting.
Uh-huh.
This guy doesn't exactly win the most talkative fellow of the year award, does he?
You ever have any problems with the locals?
Locals? They give you any trouble, you just smack them around.
Whoa.
Or you could try talking to them. Who's in charge here?
The Don.
Who?
The Don.
Right. Where is the Don?
In the temple.
Is he religious?
Ha!
So what does he do in there?
Avoids being out here.
This guy doesn't talk much. Agreed.
You don't talk much.
What do I want to talk for? I don't know you.
That's fair.
Getting anything out of you is like pulling teeth.
That's why I make such a good guard.
It's true.
All right. Let's try this question. Tell me more about these things. The ones in the excavation site.
They're disgusting. Big, insect things. I wish someone would get rid of them.
I can.
Can I? Sweet. I need paying. Say 30 gold
I
coins?
I need paying. Say 30 gold coins.
30? Yeah. It's worth that to get rid of those things.
The grave moths.
Disgusting.
Keep my gold warm. I'll be back for it.
I'm not ready to leave yet.
You must have picked up some skills to be a guard.
I know how to fight, and I can handle a crossbow.
Can you train me?
To fire a crossbow? All right. But it will cost you.
I don't really want to know about crossbows. Sorry, buddy. All right, let's go gather some stuff and then maybe deal with those moths. I know, big bad man killing moths. Ooh, there's some stuff over here. Interesting. Ah, yes, I know this place well. That is an unfortunate thing. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. I do not. No, I do not. Alright, we got some weed there. That's, intriguing, I guess. Not sure why we have a walk button. It seems, seems a little silly. I can saw wood, though it does nothing but gives me the graphic of sawing wood. To my knowledge. We'll sit here for a few seconds and see if we actually we sweat. Yeah, sweat it out. Clean those impurities from your body. Alright, there's no point in doing this. Stop sawing wood. Yeah, seemed kind of silly, didn't it? Alright, well, we're fully healed, and it looks like those moths are sitting there floating around doing mothy things. So we're gonna go deal with them in just a quick second. I think what I'd like to... We'll do it the manly way. We'll go in with a sword. That's a disgusting... Oh, gosh. They all want to eat my soul. Oh, boy. I may have bitten off more than I can chew. Maybe not. Maybe... Oh, look. People are shooting. I'm doing stuff, too, now. Come on. Come on. Yeah. One to go. I've done it flawlessly thus far. And bam. What? Like a ninja. That's right, guys. The ninja Bumpy McSquiggums are right here doing ninja Bumpy McSquiggums things. Killing disgusting insects, making gold, and making the locals happy, and making them love me. All at the same time. How many of you can say you've done that, huh? A handful, maybe? Oh gosh, I hear another one of those stupid stink rats, or sting rats, or whatever they are. Yeah, I see them. Look at them out there. Those are my bane. If you guys want to come kill those for me, I am all for it. I would be exceptionally happy if you guys came and murdered those things. There's a basic chest here. Is anybody watching me? No? Maybe we can take a peek inside, take a gander. Look at some bolts there. A fragment of a sword. What? We'll take all of that. Oh, apparently I have a quest to collect fragments of swords. Who knew? Ooh, there's another chest over here. And a pixie hat. Because, well, why not? Pixie hats are the latest... Why am I not... Get in the chest. They're the latest rage, after all. Ooh, we have a useless amulet. This wouldn't even impress a child. Okay, well, before we go off and get ourselves into trouble... Let's go back and look around at some more... Oh, gosh. There's things in that swamp. Look at them. It's a walking, like, swamp monster. I don't know. Whatever it is, it's not cool. Hey, we got a hoe. And a shovel. And another... Oh, and a pickaxe. Well, we just got all sorts of stuff, didn't we? I wonder if we can use these things yet. Let's go here with the shovel. Oh, I guess not. Is there a place to dig? I vaguely remember there being a dig site around here somewhere. Though I could be wrong. I mean, it's possible that there's a skill that you have to learn before you can dig as well. So I'm gonna probably just back up, go back to town, and get paid my big 30 coins that I made there, and we'll deal with the swamp thing guy later. Hopefully we can get some armor or clothing or anything that's a little bit stronger than what we have right now. Job done.
You needn't worry about those things in the excavation site anymore.
You killed them. Right. 30 gold coins, wasn't it? Worth every one.
Thanks. Pleasure talking to you.
Indubitably.
Right. I'll look forward to our next conversation.
Mm-hmm. Alright, don't care about crossbows. What about you, Domingo?
What do you want?
Man like you has clearly
seen some action.
Man like
you has clearly seen some action.
Well, you know... I don't like to boast, but I've crushed a few heads. If you want to eat here, you have to work.
Fair enough.
You want a free ride? Try those white robes at the monastery. They'll give you a free ride all the way to their excavation camps. And keep your paws off other people's stuff while you're here. Or you'll lose your paws.
What? I don't think I would lose my paws. That seems rather harsh.
I don't know. What do I want?
You were looking at me.
I'm new here. I'm just getting to know people.
If you don't know I'm the best fighter in the camp, then you won't be near long enough for me to care.
It's funny. Henchman probably doesn't do anything. Sam!
Hey. I've not seen you before. Who are you? A fresh-faced young man eager to experience the thrill of an outlaw's life?
Yes.
Maybe.
I can't think why else you'd be here. There are warm alehouses and welcoming brothels in the town. Food and indoctrination at the monastery.
Awesome.
Are you a woodcutter for the camp?
Just because I'm cutting wood doesn't mean I'm a woodcutter. Actually, I'm a hunter.
Yeah.
My lads and I provide meat for the camp.
Good to know.
So you lead the hunters?
Normally, yeah. But as you can see, I've got vital woodcutting work to do. So right now, my hunters are running wild like free spirits. Or they think they are.
Indeed.
Shouldn't you get someone else to cut the wood?
I'd love to, believe me. But Brogar would nail me to a tree if I left this wood unsawn.
Brogar.
One of the Don's lieutenants, the leader of the fighters, a, shall we say, powerful, single-minded man.
There we go. The reemergence of lieutenants instead of lieutenants, like the. I have to imagine that it's more than just Americans that say lieutenant. But, I mean, maybe I'm wrong. I don't know where the lieutenant came from. The first time I heard it, it cracked me up. I was like, what in the world is that? But it's apparently more and more prominent. I don't know if it's English, if it's Canadian, if it's Australian, or who exactly uses it, but it's weird. There's no F. Well, of course, there's no R in colonel, but, yeah. All right.
And you're his personal woodcutter.
For my sins.
Why does he want you to do it?
I tangled with him, and now I have to pay. We live by Brogar's laws, eh?
Do we?
Brogar's laws? Not the Don's.
The Don wants me to hunt. Brogar wants his fire stoked. You judge who's really in charge.
Interesting.
Why don't you stand up to Brogar?
Him and all his fighters, you mean?
So everyone's afraid of him.
You clearly haven't met him yet. Then you'd understand.
Will I?
He's over there. Go and introduce yourself. Then decide whether you'd stand up to him.
Sounds like a plan, but I'm not done talking to you yet, Sam.
Can you teach me to hunt?
Sure you wouldn't rather chop wood?
I was thinking more of hunting.
Then you're talking to the right man.
Can you teach me about hunting?
Alright, so we got dexterity, archery, sneak, gut animals. With this skill, you can take valuable trophies from slain animals. You can skin animals with the right equipment. You can also take other trophies. I think I'd want to do that, but I'm not 100% certain. I'm going to go back for right now.
How can I become one of the Don's men?
Firstly, I'll need to tell you a couple of things. The Don's a powerful man. Well, he was. Since we've been in this swamp, he's hidden in that temple. Hasn't been out for weeks. His wife Rachel's been trying to run the camp. She's the one you need to impress if you want to meet the Don.
Rachel. Right.
Before you charge up to her, you need to be aware of...
Brogar.
You're learning.
Alright, well that's interesting. So there's going to be a lot of talking and kind of storyline building in this game, as most good RPGs have. So please bear with me, I'll try to still fit some action in as we go through and everything else, but for now, this is what we're stuck with doing.
Why can't I get to talk to the Don himself?
If you can't get Rachel on your side, maybe you could get past the guard at the temple. Maybe.
Sounds like it could be worth a try.
True, but it's a long shot. Rachel might be your best way in.
Indubitably. Alright. Well, I don't need to know anything more about hunting right now. I don't want to talk to Brogar yet. I really want to learn about axe fighting, and I want to get an axe. But it's not really looking all that great for me. Hawkins. There's a bench. Got a bunch of guys over here. Another shovel that we can grab. Another shovel, and it looks like we could actually dig here, maybe. Not sure how. Oh, there we go. Just click it. So if you see a weird dirt pile, you can actually dig. Not sure why I'm not using the shovel to dig, but... Oh, there we go. I had to dust the ground off, because, you know, I don't want to get my shovel dirty or something odd. I don't know. It's fine. It's fine. We're digging. Trying to break the camera with the shovel. It's no big deal. And what do we have? What do we have? Show me potato salad. Or a gigantic chest that he just pulled out of the ground like a boss. What? And what was it we have? What do we have? We have the light spell and some coin. And we managed to steal some stuff, so take it. Clay's laying down, we have a basic chest, we have a beer that I'm going to totally steal because that's what I do. Basic chest, what's in it? It looks like there's some arrows, a weed reefer, and some stingers. Alright, so we'll take that. We're going to be cautious now because, well, I think, is there an autosave button? Quick save? I thought there was, but apparently not. The reason I say that is, you can die really quick in this game, and I'd rather not end up having to load from far distances, so give me a few seconds, guys. I want to take a look at the game options, input, aha! So we'll see if there's a quick save. It's F8 and F9, alright. So, I'm going to utilize this a little bit more often. I had to edit out earlier, I did die, that weird swamp thing creature, I didn't see it, and I walked into it and it murdered my soul, so I'd rather avoid that happening a second time if I can, because it was quite unpleasant and, well, really rather unfortunate, so I don't know where I want to head. I think I want my shield and sword out, though. That does seem like a pretty good idea when moving around in poorly lit areas, I guess you could say. Perhaps I can drag that thing over toward Lewis. I remember I liked Lewis. I don't remember why I liked Lewis. We'll find out.
You alone out here? What? Are you alone out here?
Yeah, yeah. Don't yell. I'm deaf.
He's the drunkard.
You see, my full of beer glass thing goes smash if you drop it.
You're drunk.
So, I'd rather be dead drunk than dead, and we're all gonna die soon anyway.
Fair enough.
You wait. When the white robe shows up, we'll all be as dead as dead men.
Mm-hmm.
White robes?
Yeah. The white robes. White. From the Inquish.
Inquisition?
Yeah. What do white robes want in a swamp? They'll end up brown robes. Ha! Stinking. Swamp.
Oh, dear.
You mean a beer bottle.
That's why I said. You got bad hearing, you know that. The bottle was right. It was here. No, here somewhere.
Yeah, what can you tell me about the white robes?
And what can you tell me about the white robes?
They're everywhere. Came from the sea, from the mainland, and now they're sweeping across the island, wrecking everything.
Have you ever met a white robe?
You're insane, huh? I'd run like a stabbed rat if I ever saw one.
I can believe it.
Where's that damn bottle? It's my bottle. Give it back, you stinking swamp.
Yep.
Don't you think you've had enough?
Enough? Enough? Oh, I can't drink enough. Have you been to the Don's camp? I can tell you once you've spent a couple of days there. You'll start on the source too, believe me. If you'd been there, you'd be me.
Huh.
Why? What's wrong with the camp?
Bunch of total assholes. Bastards. Always screwing each other over. I don't trust a single one of them. The worst bastard is Brogar. A nasty piece of work. He's a bastard's bastard.
Well, that sounds bad. Tell me more of this.
Tell me more about this Brogar.
The whole damn place is under his thumb. Officially, he's just the boss of the fighters, the Don's lieutenant, but he's more than that. Every man there's terrified of him, even his shadow's scared of him. Because that Brogar, he wants to replace the Don, doesn't he?
Whoa.
Yeah, he does.
Right.
Well,
you seem to know a lot about Brogar.
More than you think, and not just about Brogar. You get me more beer, and then I'll really tell you something.
I get you more beer, and I'll be lucky to understand you. I'll see what I can do.
Fair enough, all right.
Here, one beer for some information.
Hey, you got one.
Huh. Yeah, I did.
You're beautiful.
I know. There you go.
Here, you're a hunter. Or you were. Teach me something about it.
Now you're talking. When I got time, I'll do just that.
Okay.
Can you teach me about hunting?
Let's see. Same exact stuff. That doesn't help me at all. We'll end. We won't talk to him anymore. We want to see if we can actually get some combat going. Find anything laying around. Nope, it's not looking like it. Alright, so we're going to go back into the base camp, I guess, and from there we're going to talk to a few more lads and possibly a lady or two, and I guess we're going to have to deal with Brogar at some point. But what I might do first is see if there's anything I can actually fight, because again, we want to try to advance the story, not to sit around and talk the entire time. But I did manage to fight some mods. I did get owned a little bit by one thing, but eh. Well, let's go take a look up here and see what's over here. Maybe we find something useful, maybe we don't. But unless we check and look, we do not know what we're going to find. So, alright, sorry about that, guys. A little bit of a delay there. Constant interruptions, I tell you. It's just, it's my life. It is constantly being interrupted. I'm not sure if something good or bad was up here. I'm thinking that I might be overextending myself right now. Going into a very bad place that I shouldn't be. But we'll see. We can always attempt to retreat from something terrible eating our souls, so that's good. Oh, we'll go gather some weed, I guess. I think there was some wolves or something around here that was just, unpleasant to deal with. But, for now, I'm not seeing anything. There should be somebody at this house, if I recall correctly. Hmm. Oh, what in the heck is that? Something large over there, you see that? It's dark, but it's over there. I don't know what that is. Oh, it's some sort of horrible worm thing that we're gonna run like scared little girls away from. Hope that we can retreat from it. Oh, nope. Nope, we got stuck on a corner of something. Oh gosh! It wants to eat our souls, we don't want to die. Retreat! It's coming! Did I outrun it? Oh my goodness, that was horrible. Well, maybe we don't want to fight anything right now. Maybe that's a terrible idea. Alright, so we'll take a look around here. I guess we'll deal with the town. We definitely need armor. That's our biggest thing right now. We have absolutely no equipment, really. I mean, we have a sword and a battered piece of garbage shield, basically a piece of wood tacked together with a tin foil and maybe some I don't know, paper clips. And then we have a bow and arrow that, well, you saw that wasn't super effective either. A tree stump. Intriguing. We have a fighter over here. I have beer laying all over the place here, so if you want to get drunk, this is the place to come, and people don't seem to care if you're going to grab it up and use it, so seems like a win to me. Alright, I guess we're going to have to pull ourselves up. There we go. And we have a rogue there, and a cauldron, and a stove, and a chest. Oh, there's a woman. Nope. Don't want to talk to the woman. Sorry. A whetstone, a water trough, a forge, an anvil, all sorts of stuff. We have Craig, man. He's chilling in here. We got something else going on in here? No, it doesn't look like it. A seaman's chest. Let's open that up and take a look. Ooh, there's a ring of marksmanship. Alright, so we'll take that and we will open our inventory. And we will hopefully scroll through until we find the ring. There it is. Oops, and then we will hit the wrong button because we do that. And then we will hit... Is it C? It is C, alright. Now we are going to equip a ring. I thought we had more than one ring, but apparently that is not the case. That's okay, we're going to...
I'll need some raw meat to fry.
Okay. Lizard on a spit, apparently we can turn the lizard, and that doesn't sound appetizing at all. So we're going to stop that, and what do we have in here? We have Lorenzo. We have a rogue. Oh, and then we're going to walk outside the house. Let them go back to sleep, and then maybe we can sneak in here and steal? I'm not sure. What's up, Lorenzo?
I don't like faces I don't know well, and your face is too pretty. Slap some makeup on you and you could work the brothels.
Okay.
You know I'm new here then.
Shiny skin, gormless expression. You're not the first. It's the heap of gold in the temple. It sucks in idiots like flies to shit. But there's no one round here that wants to split their share of the Don's gold any further.
You're a fighter, right?
I took the advice my teacher gave me. Find something you like and make it your job.
Simple enough. Alright.
What's the Don going to do with the gold? Invest in swampland?
We might be stuck here now, but we're not going to be here forever. Once those religious nutcases are gone, Harbour Town will be ours.
Nice.
Then you'll see.
Alright.
Where did the Don get all his gold?
See that temple? We took it. Ooh. And guess what? It was full of gold and artifacts and stuff.
Nice.
Now it's full of guards, an ogre, and surrounded by us. There are temples all over the island. Why don't you bugger off and find your own?
Wow, this guy is very, very pleasant. You just walk in.
You just walk in and take the gold from the temple ruins.
Yeah, it's that simple.
Nice.
Go on, try it. Then you'll see the beasts that come charging out of those ruins. You have to deal with them before you get to the shiny stuff.
So you've cleared all those creatures out of the ruins?
Keen to see them, are you? All right. We'll go to a temple ruin nearby. You help me deal with the creatures there, and you can get your share of the gold.
Okay. What's the catch?
There's no catch. We clear the place and split the rewards.
Mm-hmm.
How do we split the gold?
50-50.
I'll think about it. I don't think I'm ready just yet.
All right. But don't take too long.
Perhaps that's what we'll do in the next episode. So for now, we're going to hop out here. We go around back. We're going to ninja the dude's beard through the window, or the fake window. We're getting all soaked right now, which is unpleasant for sure. Oh, I can't ninja the beard through the window? That makes me sad. It's okay, though. It's okay. And I think at this point, I'm honestly probably going to break off the episode. Guy's sleeping with his head on the fire. That's kind of creepy. I think we're going to break off the episode in just a minute. We're not quite to that point yet. We're pretty close, though. Well, we talked to Craig, man. I don't want to talk to Brogard yet because he's a douche and I don't want to deal with his douchery. I guess we'll go chug some water and then we'll, I guess, we'll go help the guy deal with the giant worm. I think we can do that. So we're going to get some water in us, and then we're going to go deal with the worm. And then we'll break off the episode. It will be done, and wonderful, and glorious in all ways. And we'll even say beforehand, because, well, though normally I don't mind showing you guys mistakes, it kind of slows the game down tremendously, and it's already a really long game, so I'm going to attempt to not do it, but I'll let you guys know if I do die. And if it's ridiculously hilarious, I may actually show you guys anyway. Alright, let's hunt this worm.
How about I help you hunt this worm?
Oh, that's good of you. Tell you what, if we kill that thing together, I'll give you 30 gold.
Sweet.
I hope you're well prepared. Don't want your death on my conscience.
Me too. Let's go kill this rotworm.
Let's go kill this rotworm.
That's the spirit. Right. Ready your weapon and stay close to me.
Alright.
Come on.
Well, I got killed by the rotworm, guys. Told you. If I made a mistake, I'd let you know. Fortunately, the rotworm kind of owned me. We fought it in a pretty terrible spot. And again, it's kind of dark. Oh gosh, he just shot some sort of green slime at us. Come on, Doug. You gotta do something, buddy. We can't just man up and fight the rotworm by ourselves. Unfortunately, we were one hit from killing it, and we did really well up to that point. But the downside was, it managed to back out of the range of us being able to hit it, and, well, then it just turned and unloaded on me and murdered my soul. It was unfortunate, unpleasant, and, well, quite bad. Really. Alright, this time we have the rotworm cornered, and bam, I even got the last hit on it. Not that it matters. Alright, so we got some teeth and some raw something another done there. It was pretty sweet. He's running over here. Is there more to it, or is that it? Oh, What's up, Doug?
See, that's what being a hunter is all about.
Nice.
The thrill of the hunt, buzz of the kill. Oh, that's made my week, that has.
Sweet. Sweet, 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 sweet.
I've killed that worm. You don't need to worry about it.
One less worm is no bad thing. Here, have 30 gold for your trouble.
Thank you.
Hey, if you're going to the camp, can you take this raw meat with you?
Yeah, I can.
I always need food there. Just give it to Rachel, the cook. I'm going to stay here, see if I can spot my next challenge.
That I will totally do for you. Let's trade again. I think I've gathered some extra random stuff. And I think I want to gather the other tool that you didn't give me. I have a hoe. I have a couple of pickaxes. I don't need two. I'm not sure. Okay, I just left click. Alright, I don't need multiple things. I have the tooth cutter, but I don't have the wing clipper, so we're going to get that. I didn't go with the dexterity thing. I sold you all those things so far. What else do we got? We have a fragment of a sword. We don't want to get rid of that. Stinger, we can get rid of. Some more wing dust. That's fine. What else do we have that we don't really want or need? And a couple more teeth that looks like we gathered up as well. So we're going to trade that. And yes, we'll add the 59 gold to it. And we will quit. And that's it. So we're going to head back to camp, and we're going to talk to Rachel. And, well, actually, we're not going to talk to Rachel. We're just going to head back into camp, and then we're going to leave it at that. So I want to thank you guys for joining me in this episode of Risen. This is episode 3, and, well, we didn't get a whole heck of a lot done, but we got a decent amount done. We talked to quite a few people, and that's a lot of the work sometimes. Just babbling to the different fools. So the fact that we've babbled to several of them, we've got about half the talking done. We did a couple of quests. I mean, we're not terribly far behind. So everything's working out pretty well. And that's going to do it this time, guys.